Once upon a time, in a land far, far away. Nah, not like that. I'm only joking. But I am going to tell you a story. It's not your story. It's my story. A story like you've never seen before. But you want a proper story, huh? Then I must tell you something of my people and my land. Then you can see the story and know it. This land began in the beginning. Yulunguru, that great water governor, he traveled here. Yulunguru made all this land and he made this water and he made this swamp that stretches long and gives us life. I come from a water hole in this land you longer made. I was looking like a little fish in my water hole. Then my father come near my water hole. I asked him for my mother. I wanted to be born. My father pointed out one of his wives. "That's your mother," he told me. I waited until the right time, and I went just like that into her vagina. Then my father had a dream. That dream made him know she had a little one inside her. That little one was me. When I die, I will go back to my water hole. I'll be waiting there like a little fish, waiting to be born again. You didn't know all that, did you? Huh? But it's the true thing. It's always like that for my people. Now we have to find where the story is. The story I'm going to tell you. We have to go back long time, back to the time of my ancestors. Listen now. I can hear them. They're coming. My ancestors.
Ah.
This wise-looking one is Minglulu. Then his younger brother, Dandy. And then the other ones. Too many names to remember. That one is Jigger. Jigger talk too much, but maybe he heard something. The ancestors are making canoes for goose egg hunting. They cut the barks off the trees. And they talk about women, like always. They make fun at Dayindi. They know Dayindi is liking the young wife of his brother Minglulu. This is first time Dayindi hunt the magpie geese. There is many things Dayindi never seen before. And there is much for him to learn on this hunting.
Mari nyukung miyal banden mi nane bener kan
Minglulu knows it's true about the wrong feeling of his young brother.
Tenyar bor tenat Kawan, mai luri, kira apa engkau ini?
The men will carry the bark to the swamp. Minglulu will tell Dayindi that story to help him live the proper way. It is Minglulu's story for Dayindi back then. And it is my story for you now. It is a good story, But you better listen, eh? Maybe you like the Hindi. Maybe this story will help you live proper way. And here is that story. It is long, long time ago. Dayendi is still a little fish in his water hole. All the ancestors, that Minglulu, Jigir, and even the old Suzra, all of them little fish in their water holes. All their fathers and fathers before that, they're still little fish in their water holes all over this land, waiting to be born. That's how long ago this time is that we are in now. The time that we see now is after the beginning. It is after the big flood came that covered the whole land. Look at that flood. You can nearly see it. We are so long ago now. It is after Yulunguru, great water governor, named the trees and the birds and the plants and the people. It is after Yulunguru gave the all ancestors big ceremony of the Jungwan, which give us the law we all learn. It is after the people learn to live to that law. After then, but a long, long time ago. And in that ancient time, there lived an ancient ancestor. This ancient ancestor was called Rijimiril. Rijimiril was a warrior, a proud one. He had wives and children just like we have now. And he followed the law, which is the same law as the law now. The stories of our people are very old. Sometimes they take long time to tell, days even. Mingululu is telling the Hindi some of the story while they carry the bags. Proper trees for canoes grow far away from the swamp. The storytelling must stop for a while. There is more work to do before the men hunt the geese. They must put the box in the water to soak.
Hey,
One bark already soaked is put on the fire to make it hot and soft. The story of Reggie Merrill can go on. The first wife Reggie Merrill had was called Panalunchu. Panalunchu was wise and she was important. The bark is almost ready. They must cool it down to make it easy to bend. The Indian learns by watching. That is the way we do it with our people. But we better keep this story going. Number two wife of Reggie Merrill was called Nawalingo. Nawalingo was a bit of a jealous one, but she had eyes that sometimes flew at other men. Ah, that number three wife, she was a young one. She was called Munanjar. Munanjar was beautiful one. She was quiet as a sleeping baby. Reggie Merrill also had younger brother, just like Taindi was Mingululu's younger brother. Reggie Merrill's brother was called Yeralpril. Yeralpril had no wives yet and none promised. He thought he should have one. And the wife he thought he should have was Munanjar. It was not right to him that his brother had three wives, but he himself had none.
Bulluk nyone jawal payerek ka meal manin me penjerek helkamja. Kenyum when you are coming here, madam, they are all fine.
Papa, I am here. My karma is not good. Can you not hear?
Hey, Ibrahim, Marco, Gorkran, you guys are all nene.
The young man lived in Singleman's camp, away from the main camp. They lived there to learn the law and man's ways. Yeralpril too lived in the Singleman's camp. Even though it was long walking to Reggie Merrill's camp, Yeralpril's eyes could already see that young Munanjar. his mind would wander off to be with her. Sometimes his legs would make his body follow. He thought about how to really see Munanjali. Maybe he would just walk into the camp and pretend another reason.
What the hell?
But maybe Bonalunji's eye would be too sharp. That day near the camp was haircut day. Irapu thought maybe he could see Munanjali from the distance. The one who said that joke is Pirinbirin, who lived in the same camp as Vijimiril. Pirinbirin had two wives and a belly big as a mountain. He was always eating too much, but his favorite thing of all was honey. He would search for it, beg for it, and sometimes even steal it. Yes. I nearly forgot that sorcerer. The sorcerer was old and very powerful. He had good magic and bad magic. He lived by himself to keep his magic secret. Now watch carefully, because on this day I'm talking about, something happened. There was a stranger. Maybe that stranger had a right to visit this land. Maybe he had a sacred waterhole there. I don't know anymore. The story is too old. But that stranger had not signaled that he was coming. He had the smell of someone very dangerous. The stranger spoke language Vijimiril could not understand very well.
kerana orang ini jiban, orang ini kerana korup la.
When they knew this stranger was part of magic, the bones of the man were shaking. They did not trust this stranger with the covered prick. He was not carrying anything to trade. Now you can see the canoes are nearly done. Only one bark is left to do. Now then you can learn what happened with his ancestors. Some of the ancients wanted to kill this stranger, but Rijimiriril didn't want to start a war. The stranger was given food to show respect. Soon he would be gone, but the bad feeling about him stayed behind. Far away, the sorcerer was listening in his mind. He heard the man talking about the stranger. The sorcerer came through the bush to the man. He made him listen to him. He warned him about the magic. It's not wise to leave shit just lying there. A sorcerer can do things with it. When the branches rub in the wind, it makes a sore throat. Then the sorcerer got himself ready. He looked all around the camp He looked everywhere for any magic that stranger left behind. After a long time, he was finished.
So my magic will be like your heart, will be like your heart, God, I like your God, I will.
The men are happy to go in the swamp. It's hard for Dayendi. It's his first time to pull the canoe. Listen to the men honking like this. Dayendi scared a crocodile. At first, nothing bad happened to Rijamiril and his people after the stranger left. Life for the ancient ancestors passed as it always did, as it had since the beginning. Rijamiril's wives behaved like wives always do. Brenburin behaved like himself. Rijamiril went hunting. And the women went to get food, chattering like magpies. The single men suddenly went bush. They seen Brenburin coming. Now Alingo went with her friends to be away from Banalingo. And Biren Biren was making spearheads, singing a happy honey song. Year April is trying to be tricky. With all his family behaving like they always do, now we know why Rijimiril went hunting. But that Rijimiril was still a hard worker for his three wives. He was always trying to be fair and nice to all of them.
Why would you go out there again?
Even sometimes to the younger one. Can you hear all them gumang? That magpies? Soon they will go on way to hunt geese and collect the eggs. Tandy will go with Mingululu to learn the swamp and hear more stories. And this story is now growing like a young tree that is flowering for the first time. Back in that long ago time, maybe someone done the wrong thing. Or maybe the spirits were angry for no reason. But anyway it was, the lives of the ancients were about to change.
Naleng obalai ban.
That second wife of Bridget Muriel, she just disappeared. Like she flew away with the keys. The men sat down to talk about what maybe happened to her. Time passed. Life without Nawalengo became normal, even to Reggie Muriel. But then everything changed again. An old uncle came to visit.
Ah, you're a little bit of a Kuhan korang ngarabaitan. Naya yang ngarabome. Tarnya me ma. Nala yang ukan na. Ka ngono ko ngolon bor. Yernya lalu kabelak. Yol nge ngono ko me nyen nyen. Nyen nyen. Nala yang ukarnya me. Baikan arguaw. Karuan drene. Pambem.
Bridgemiral was right. Normally, always with that stranger, the uncle's eyes had seen it themselves. The men decided to get Nawaling back. So the engines made everything ready to send out a war party. Everybody was ready for war. The men talked about the planning.
Kama kare kare mang dalo kabri ni pininya
alme kele manana meal lemuru galan ma
Mereka Yuta. Tujuan itu.
Nyano.
Perkara mana yang mel. Kanyo naman nyar para pagi ma. Ah. Ayram mage. May alkwer gini. Mare. Wo jame mag. Kamu no ho jame mag. Kira alpare. May alkwer. Ange.
Macam macam ni mail.
Yeah. Yeah, mudi bud. Macam mana yang awak mudi bud? Awak dah tahu kibin nak.
I have to tell you something more about my people. If a man gets killed or dies, then his younger brother looks after dead man's wives. They become wives of his younger brother. That's why Yiralpril could not go. Only the young boys was left in single man's camp. Yiralpril's mind began to wander. Pretty soon, his body followed. He was thinking, with all the men gone, maybe you could come closer to Munajar. But he didn't reckon with Panalincha. Jaindi thinks about Yiralpril and Munajar. Their destinies were like butterflies in the air. They could go here, they could go there. Even the soft wind could change their direction forever.
Oh,
The men must sleep on the swamp while they're hunting. It's too far to go back all the time. But normal camp is not possible. There's too many crocodiles and not enough dry land. The men must be cooking and eating and sleeping in the trees, on platforms they're building. Up there in the branches, they will be safe. Diende will soon find out what happened to War Party. Everyone came back safe. Not one angry spear was thrown.
Korup gunde binyangan, kawin yung binyanyere. Mol korup agral le jamur jene.
Maya.
Kau nomor nyo ne. Ambal ini mel mel kor kor bini nyangan ne.
Mel.
Ya ambal apa lawan nge? Kau nomor ini.
Yo.
Kau nomor pelajar ini mel kenal yang kau nye. Kemungkinan pelajar ini kau pelajar kerumban.
Mel.
Kapan meeting nyangan?
Suara kami mengacau tambak ni, kau doi, alar, pernah kau dapat lebih mo, kau lebih bo, cuma dapat lebih menunggu kau dalam, anak kau lebih ka, kau mekau lebih nekwan. Nalo mel kra gorman nale ukan yen wile arma haru kon mel kra gorman nyalu yul ngoy.
There was nothing Richmond could do. No one believed him anymore. He became quiet and angry and sad. He was possessed by bad spirit, like his proper soul been taken away from him. The trouble Rijimiriel had was only just beginning. The bad spirit that lived in his head escaped. That bad spirit made biggest trouble of all.
Pani di nomor dua lah, jangan berpani sekayu cul tu, eh. Jangan berpani sini bule.
Pernah jangan yang kau cium me.
Ber. Kau
tegar mereka nyobong eh. Kau ni berpani berpani sini je, jangan berpani le. Hai. Begitu berani lepas ni, jangan berani. Jangan yang luar ni, orang gay pun le. Hai, ada. Orang kaya ni yang ni, kapal baru ni cari. Jalak je.
Apa aja, pak? Pak jalankan kamu. Tahu pelanggan mana, pak?
Angker mana ke? Nirgung gaje, mil temar ke?
Alma mama. Ya, ya. Kamu.
Kere.
Yo.
Ikan. Orang berkir mana?
Agar cara,
oh, ngarik. Oh, jangan bangun je, kamar cie ngarik. Jangan bangun je.
Mana biga?
Tolong ini buat zaman me.
Karena kau pay na biga.
Jangan kejiban.
Awak kuat.
Mor pun ini mungkin jauh berleh.
Hah? Ya kulit berikan. Alkur kejale. Mengajar kerbau
kan? Anjel le.
Kuda kerbau kan?
Ma.
Anu yang berjaga jaga ni alat kejapan. Lair pun. Jauh itu kepala. Jauh itu kepala. Jauh itu kepala ngari. Kamu.
Cari orang nomor eh.
Lair.
Malgarinye,
per,
per,
kenyalai,
kenyalai ni,
kaki,
arwinya ni ni,
per,
per.
Jangan nyanyi bertuah, nyer penelaman guru menengah ke, jeral per.
The Indi is impatient to hear what will happen to the young ones.
But the story is growing into a large tree now, with branches everywhere. All the parts of the story have to be told for proper understanding. Mingulu keeps going on the same branch. Those two ancestors, Rijimiril and Birinbirin, done the wrong thing when they tried to hide the body. They didn't hide that body well enough.
What?
At first, that stranger didn't believe Rijimiril. Rijimiril would not change his words. The only thing to do was follow the law. Rijimiril could not refuse Makarata payback ceremony, where the stranger and his men could throw spears at him until he got hit. As the two groups worked out the Makarata, Rijimiril knew he was in a danger he couldn't get away from. Night is coming to the tree platforms. The men sit near their little fires. The smoke helps to keep the mosquitoes away. They talk about the hunting. There's lots of gumang egg this year. The telling of the destiny of Rijimiril must wait until night becomes empty of black. Now it is morning. The men go out to do more hunting of gumang and their eggs. Mingululu wants to know if Daindi has learned anything yet. Daindi say only thing he learned is Mingululu take long time to tell the story. Mingululu answers, A good story must have proper telling. Back then, older time ago, it was also a time of goose egg gathering. Payback, Makarata, was to be this time, far across the other side of the swamp. Rijimirel was heavy in his heart. This time, Yiralpuril could go to lend his spirit to his older brother. Afraid to never see her husband again. Birinbirin could not go. He was too fat to cross the swamp in a canoe.
Na, koko, ever get part of him? Why get in your way? You don't go
It was a bad time. As the men went out to cross the swamp, they were thinking of what Rijimirel had to face. Maybe that strangest mob could throw the spears good and straight. Then Rijimirel would have a spear rod through him pretty soon. But that was the law. Rijimirel knew that law. He knew it was the way of his people. He knew the people needed the law so they could stay living right way with the right land. And he knew he'd broken the law.
Hey, mother.
Without the Makarata, there would be a bad war between the two tribes. There was no turning back.
Very well.
Mingolo tells Taindi that Rijimirel needed Makarata partner. Someone who would face the spears with him. The other tribe was satisfied whichever one got speared. It was a dangerous thing to be Makarata partner. He could get speared instead of Rijimirel. Yiralpuril knew it. and waited his time. Without Will, I did with the men. If we couldn't have any wives, or we couldn't have Munanjar, he might as well be spared or dead. Finally, Regent Mitterill agreed. The goose egg hunters come together to eat. Dayindi is proud of his hunting. Mingololo will go on with the story when they are eating. We can't wait that long, because it was time for Makarata spears to start flying. Richmiril and Yiralbril dance like ghosts between the spears. They danced so hard, they were nearly invisible. The spears seemed to be passing right through them. The warriors from the other tribe threw their spears until their arms were getting tired. That's how hard those two brothers were dancing. But Regent Mitterill was not a ghost. His legs were human, and one spear too many came flying. The goose egg hunting is nearly over for now, but there is still some of the story left for me to tell you. That one spear too many had hit Regent Mitterill right in his gut. He was injured all right, but not so bad that he should die. The other tribe, they were satisfied. The law had been followed. Justice had been done.
അറിഞ്ഞും കുറയുള്ളമ്മ തിന്ന് പറ്റിയ
Rijimiril still believed it was the stranger who took Nalingu. It made him too proud to let the men carry him back. He wanted to show the stranger and his own men he was strong and angry. But he was not strong enough to pull all the way across the swamp. And the blood that was leaving his body made him too weak to walk by himself. Vanalunju knew the leaves to use to make the wound better. She knew what to get to make her husband stronger. The men are near the end of the journey. Dayindi is now interested in all the story. He waits to hear what happened to Rijimiril. Rijimiril did not get stronger. In his weakness, he called out Nawalingu to bring him water. But Nawalingu didn't come. A bad spirit took over Rijimiril's body. He did not have the strength to fight it off. That stranger's tribe might have used some sorcery. Maybe on the spear there was some sorcery. Or maybe on Rijimiril himself. And there is only one way to fight sorcery.
When you jump on the ladder, you like a malala.
The sorcerer could do no more. He was overcome by great sadness. People know. See, they know. They come out of the bush from everywhere. They come for Original. And see how Original makes one very big effort. Maybe his last effort. Slowly he gets up. And look at him get up while he's still got the strength. Slowly he walks to the middle of the space in the camp. And there, near the fire, so that everyone can see, Richard Mitterill begins to dance his own death dance. Soon the clapsticks will join him, and the didgeridoo, and then singing. Here the clapsticks start. The didgeridoo. As Original dances his own death dance. Becoming weaker. But see how he keeps dancing until all his strength will be gone. Now he's getting tired. Now his strength is finished. And he lies down on the ground. Now the warriors finished the death dance for Ritimiru. Regimiral is waiting for them to start singing again. He wants them to sing his death song for him, so that all his fathers will know that he's dying and come to him. Sing. You think he might be dead, but he's only waiting for his singing. Like his brown buff and bottom. See his foot move. That's to show he is listening. That is going to die, and he's telling his people. Now he is lying there. His heart is still beating, but he's already dead. Look, look, our grandfather gone into his heart to help get his soul out of there. Even his heart is still now. But he wants them to keep singing a bit longer to help him find his ancestors. Then they must prepare him for his journey. Sign of his water hole on him. That means his spirit can find its way back to its water hole. There to be born again. Mm-hmm. now they are chasing his soul away. Because sometimes it doesn't want to leave. And there it goes on its journey. Dayindi is learning one important thing for his life. He's learning to be patient. But you're impatient to see the rest of the story, huh? I know that. So I'll tell you what happened. Rijimiril's soul was just gone to his waterhole. It was not the stranger who took Nalini, and she did not run away. It was that Cross River mob took her. They traded her to a desert tribe far away. She escaped from them and took nearly a season to walk all the way back. And now her husband was dead. The men had to show their warriors. They made a lot of noise about going to war against Cross River men. But inside their heads, it was not like that. They were happy when Birindirin came to talk to them.
What am I your mother me? Very, very kind. I get a problem over here.
There were days and months of ceremony of the dead. all the proper things were done. At last, the spirit of the dead man was proper back where his belonging was. The men are getting close to home. Tahindi knows the story is nearly at its end. Some of the men go back to their own tribe. Maybe they meet again next ceremony. Or maybe next season of goose egg gathering. Finally, Yiralpuril could be with Monanjara.
Marquina Pala.
And finally, Dindi had the end of the story. It was not what he expected. And they all lived happily ever after. No, I don't know what happened after that. Maybe that Dindi found a wife. Maybe he didn't. It was like that for my people. But now you've seen my story.